down players and coach and start questioning.
Some general thoughts, Coach, on finding a way to win against a pretty good ball club.
It's been happening all year. We just find a way. You know, I'm not real crazy about our defense tonight, but we find a way. We find a way. I'm very, very proud of the team, of our team. Very, very proud.
Devin, can you talk about the free throws after they pulled within one? What are you feeling when you're at the line there?
Yeah, towards the end they started really trapping a lot, so we really needed somebody to knock down those free throws, and as a point guard, I was supposed to do go to the ball and I knocked them down.
Totally confident?
Yeah, I was confident.
Yeah, just talk about the third quarter a little bit, and anybody, any of you guys can answer it. It seemed like both teams didn't seem like they were getting much separation, and finally you guys were able to kind of pull away there in that late part of the third quarter. What happened?
Well, I don't have my guy to answer, but I'm just going to say that, you know, that team is a mirror of our team. You know, we played basically the same way. So the bottom line is, you know, we just gutted it out. We just got it out. And again, it's what we've been doing all year.
Quincy, walk us through that play that resulted in two fouls on you, ended up getting disqualified. Pretty intense play.
He went up for a dunk. I blocked it. Obviously, I got the foul. I shouldn't have reacted that way. I should have just, you know, went back to great play. But you know, it's over with.
Coach, what does it say about your team's resilience? I mean, you had Devin in foul trouble early, midway in the third quarter, fourth quarter. Quincy fouled out. What does it say about your team?
They never say die. They never say we're done. You know, we play until the very last second of every game. You know, it's just like being in the gym. Gym is war when we go at each other. It's war. So when we come out, you know, we kind of got an idea of what we got to do to be successful. Proud of you.
How comfortable was it having Devin at the line at that time? I think they rolled off, what, 9 straight points, and all of a sudden you're in a game again.
You know, I feel very comfortable. Anytime my guys step to the line, I feel comfortable. You know, I mean, they've been doing it all year. It'd be something different than it's been going on all year. So when I see us going to the foul lines, I'm pretty happy.
A lot of the chatter before this game was that this game was kind of the de facto two-way state championship. How tough is it going to be to regroup after a, you know, a hard and difficult game like this with, you know, a quick turnaround time and come back tomorrow?
Well, you know, we never looked at it that way. You know, tomorrow these guys will be ready to play. Every game this year, I mean, they'll come out slow, but eventually they'll pick up on what we got to do, and they'll be ready to play.
Any of you guys, how much do you think it helps having been here before last year, that experience playing this environment?
It helps a lot, you know. Last year being here, we had a tough game in the championship, but we already know that time to get a second ring is going to be even harder, so we're just going to come out. All of us is going to be our last high school game, so we're just going to leave it all on the floor.
Matthew, how much do you think your guys' blank bothered them at times, like on the glass and even on the perimeter? Could you tell that kind of making a difference
from
some of their shot selection and things like that?
I wasn't bothered very much. We're a very long team. We bother the other team a lot on the offensive end and defensive end. We get a lot of rebounds and we play smart.
Any of you guys can answer this. I mean, you guys have been in so many close games against quality teams. Even when you guys got up by 12, it seemed like, especially after Quincy got fouled out, it seemed like things kind of slipped away a little bit. Talk about that and just being able to regroup again and find ways to win games that, you know, maybe you should lose.
Like you said, I was been there before. Mm-hmm. All of the guys trust each other. Mm-hmm. It's a certain trust, and being there before creates a certain bond. You know what I'm saying? Like, when we go on the stretch, it's just, we all know we've been there before. We all know who can do what, who plays what role, and we just stick together and we did tonight.
Coach, did you know going into the game that you were going to go zone? Is that just your defensive principle, or had you scouted the team?
We saw them on one film, and we felt pretty good about us, coaches and I sit down and had a long conversation about it, and we felt good. We said, whether we win it or we'll lose it, I think the zone is good enough for us. Yeah, I mean, it's helped us throughout the years. You know, we play man, we play zone, we track and press and what have you. But we didn't have the rhythm that I thought that we should have had to switch a defense like that. You know, I got Chris Fitzgerald out there. We got Quincy out there. We got Matt and Devin and a host of other characters. So I'm very, very confident in our guys till the end.
Hey, talk about Hicks. He really gave you guys a kind of a boost at the start of the game.
Yeah, he's really our sixth star. Mm-hmm. He does a good job. He really does.
What's the average for you, though?
He's averaging like between 9 and 10 points a game. Solid.
Yeah.
Solid. He does some things. You know, he's also a piece of the puzzle, just like the other 12 guys.
Well, just talk about, you know, just having another opportunity to play tomorrow for a state championship, coach and then the players.
That's probably one of the greatest feelings that you could have. You know, we made it. You know, all the hard work now shows. Mm-hmm. So it's nothing like it. Ask these four guys up here.
Yeah, just every answer. Yeah.
Just knowing that we're going back to a state championship, it shows that all the work that we put in during the season, going at each other in practice and everything, is paying off. So tomorrow we've got to go out there and handle business.
I mean, we're here now, but I mean, like, we got a whole game to play tomorrow. So we'll get ready for that. Win one, win five.
You guys play some tough opponents throughout the season. How do you, is Glen Park up there, it's one of the tougher teams that you had to play against?
Yeah, they definitely were a tough team.
Yeah, we got tough.
They're a mirror of us.
Play hard.
Very aggressive. Very aggressive.
What was it like matching wits with Mike Glick? I know you guys had some battles, old Catholic League battles.
You know, for the Catholic League days. And, you know, it was always a battle. I knew when we had to go up against him and his team, I know it was going to be tough. He reminded me of me, and I know I remind him of, you know, we've just gone through so much together, me and Mike Glick. Great guy.
Good job, fellas.
Well, thanks, guys.
Thanks.